hope that you and Rush and Alice in general can create more than the other methods of AI. So thank you for what you're doing. One thing to be careful though, I think, I don't know if it's necessarily about your system, but within AI, is it's based on training data from the past. And with doctors and insurance companies, there's also a cat and mouse game trying to get more money out of each other. So what might be true now, that might be changing in the future. So there might be always a need for further calibration as the situation develops.
Thank you. I echo what Jim said. Dr. Chien always surprises us with every prompt with some innovative ideas. I have very short comments in that in this analysis, I think you use the DRG and the patient's pattern to do the large analysis. Is that possible? The doctor also has a role in this whole process. But it's just like, to me, it's just like a teacher to give a diagnosis to students writing something. So doctor, in this case, is just like a writer. Are there any rater effect in this whole process? That means if we use facet analysis, put doctor as a facet to the analysis, whether we will find a little bit different results. I'm just curious, not necessarily.
We are intended really simple for the teacher or doctor, for the doctor. Who will not know anything about the large model? Like the AI and the count. They just answer their response to the counting. They only know that the red bubble. The red bubble gets tell them that you should alert, you should be alert, and you should be write down and can hear answer or reason for the response or something. In the teachers and students did the same. They just want to know the additional information or the unexpected response to the teacher, to students. The black box, language model, is cannot do anything about it. You just know that. Like AI, you just using the fancy recognition. You just know that the difference, but you should not get the algorithm.
Thank you very much. Big applause for this. Thank you very much.